Hi, welcome to Movie Review with Daniel, and today I'll be doing a movie review on Death Music. Death Music is a 2020 American romantic movie directed by Gregor Chaudhant, and is an adaptation of Tim Whitney's 2001 novel Death Music. Death Music told the story of two unwanted loners drawn into a bizarre triangle in a remote fishing village on the coast of Western Australia. But the novel's settings was always its most vibrant character, with Whitney dissecting and elegizing the gorgeous ash mythical wilderness of Australia's largest state in expansive passages. In that sense, director Gregor Jordan's adaptation is faithful to Whitney's novel to a fault, working hard to provide postcard perfect views of Western Australia while never seeming as engaged with the film's characters. And yet that proves a far bigger obstacle centered on characters who act without much in the way of logic, with much of its dialogue confined to clip bursts of unsatisfying Hemingwayism. Death Music is a fine looking romance that never finds the right key. The film largely focuses on George, a former nurse shrouded in a passionless marriage with Jean, an older, recently widowed fisherman who lords over the fishing town of White Point, worshipped by the salt of the earth locals who barely designed to speak to his city's slacker wife. While skinny dipping near their seaside mansion one evening, Georgie happens upon a fisherman scavenging for lobsters in a small motorboat, his dog left tied on the beach. This is Lou Fox, a Tatikon local outcast who once played in the family folk music band. Driven by an unspecified tragedy to renounce music, "I don't play anymore, I don't ever listen," and heck out of a major, living as an illegal poacher. On her way to Perth, a short time later, George's car breaks down, and she hardly seems surprised when Lou comes pottering up the road behind her. No sooner has she bagged in, he's given her a lift into the city, than she lays out her intentions. "I'm not a very faithful fishwife." Lou barely registers the come on, but allows himself to be drawn into a truce with her anyway. This is not before Jim discovers both the affair and Lou's encroachment on his fishing territory. As far as love triangle goes, this one is initially low on an acute angle. Jim barely seems surprised to learn that his wife has gone astray. Georgie appears to have a little tying her to her marriage or to the town, and Lou is too busy being annoyed by his past to notice any of the trouble he's causing, spending most of his scenes swaying catatonically into the middle distance and holding imaginary conversations with his dead niece, Bird. After the local fisherman deal Lou some shockingly sadistic payback for poaching in their waters, Lou heads north for a particularly remote island off Australia's northwestern coast, and Georgie decides to follow. It is here that the film arrives at what should be his crescendo, with Lou hitchhiking toward his doom. Christopher McCandless and Georgie races to find him, and Jordan locks into a previously elusive rhythm, but this character has been so obviously defined that the pulse pounding finally, as well executed as it is, never cuts as deep as it should. Though played by McDonough, George's character loses the most in the transition from page to screen. We are told she has a drinking problem, even though we have not seen her get tipsy maybe once, and once in which she is forced to visit her estranged wedding family is so bizarrely out of sync with the tone of the rest of the film that one wonder why the subplot wasn't cut entirely. Considering the abundance of Marie Queen name OC actors, it is curious that such a quintessentially Australian film features an American and a Scottish woman in its two largest roles, but both do as well as they can with difficult characters. Yet, the real stars here are the location scout who unearthed such gorgeous vistas, from the emerald waters of Esperance to the almost extraterrestrial landscapes of the Dampier Peninsula. Thanks for watching today's review. Please feel free to hit the like and subscribe button and leave your comments in the comment box below.